large food poisoning can be pretty unpleasant, with vomit at one end and diarrhea at the other. But sometimes it can be deadly. Meet Listeria, a microbe with a very special way of hijacking your cells, and it might even kill you in the process. I'm Anna Rothschild, and this is Gross Science. A single Listeria bacterium is only about 1/100 the width of a human hair. But don't let its small size fool you. A Listeria infection, called listeriosis, is a serious disease that can kill up to 20% of people affected, and it's especially deadly to children, pregnant women, and the elderly. It starts by growing on our food, anything from dairy to meat to fruits and vegetables. And it's even tough enough to survive and reproduce in the freezer. If the food isn't adequately washed or cooked, Listeria gets a free ride down your digestive tract. When it gets absorbed by the small intestine, Listeria has to face our white blood cells.
Halt!
These cells usually protect us by engulfing disease-causing agents, trapping them in tiny cellular jails, these compartments called phagosomes. And that's exactly what starts to happen. It may seem like Listeria's met its match, until 2 weeks later, when the white blood cell starts to ripple and bulge ominously.
Uh-oh.
It turns out, getting engulfed was all part of Listeria's plan. Once inside, it makes holes in the phagosome within minutes and escapes into the gooey interior of the cell.
Ha-ha!
Then it hijacks the cell's skeleton to move around inside. Unlike our bone skeletons, cell skeletons are almost like Legos, tiny proteins that assemble where they're needed and disassemble where they're not. But Listeria steals a special molecule from its host that causes the skeleton to assemble behind it. As the skeleton grows, it pushes the bacterium along like a cellular rocket. En route, Listeria gathers nutrients, grows, and reproduces. Each time these rockets hit the outer membrane of the cell, it ripples and stretches until the army of Listeria bursts through. At that point, the bacteria can puncture their way into neighboring cells, or they can ride your bloodstream to reach your liver, spleen, and even your brain. And in these late stages, the infection can become deadly. Now, listeriosis is actually quite rare, but when there is an outbreak, these bacteria can travel through our mass food production system into the bodies of many people. So for the last several years, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention have taken a new step to stop outbreaks. Whenever there's an infection, scientists sequence the listeria's DNA and compare it to other cases of infection. That way, they can use the eating patterns of patients with genetically similar infections to track down contaminated food sources. This new technique may have contributed to the declining numbers of people infected during each outbreak. Still, the recent outbreak in May 2016 is a reminder to stay cautious. So rinse and scrub produce and cook animal products thoroughly before eating them. And if you're wondering if your food might be contaminated, visit foodsafety.gov for information about food recalls. These simple steps can help prevent this crafty little bacterium from finding its way inside you. Ew. Got a question about Listeria? Let me know in the comments. And for more gross science, hit subscribe.